So you know what usually happens when you roll a ball down a hill. No matter the size of the ball or the size of the hill, the ball will obviously roll downhill following the pull of gravity. But would you believe that a ball could actually start rolling downhill and then turn around and start rolling back uphill against gravity? Well, Einstein didn't think so, but he was actually wrong.
And in this video, for the first time, you can see it happen for yourself. This is my friend and colleague Keith, who recently proved something pretty unbelievable. Even though I didn't believe Keith at first, my mind started to change when I went home and did this simulation. It's just a ball dropped on a rotating cone. You can see that the ball starts rolling down and then starts rolling back up. But does it work in the real world? Well, Keith, along with some of our other colleagues, built a cone that looks sort of like a disc, but it actually has a 1 degree angle. You can see it's a cone because these marbles roll toward the edge. But when the cone's spinning, look what happens to the balls. They don't roll to the edge, they just stay on the cone and roll around in a circle, and sometimes they roll back toward the center. But if somebody tells you a ball can roll uphill, you probably want to see a more dramatic hill, something a little steeper. After working out some equations with Keith, we figured out that this would work with a 15 or 20 degree cone, but it would have to actually be 4 feet in diameter, and it would have to be spinning so fast that the edge would be moving 25 miles per hour. So to get this huge cone designed and built, I went to an engineering company, and we started putting it together. Using this enormous rotating cone and this basketball, I'm going to show you a gravity-defying phenomenon. The ball starts by rolling down the cone and then starts rolling back up against gravity. Einstein did think about balls rolling on spinning surfaces, but he didn't think friction would have a big enough effect to do anything like this. So how does something so unintuitive actually work? Well, in the next episode, I'll explain how it works using a record player and a few treadmills. Yeah, I'm going to the gym. And if you want more What the Physics, please subscribe and hit that little bell button so you get notifications when new episodes come out.
Okay, Greg, let's see it.
Oh, no.
Oh, where did Greg? Oh! I'm scared. Went straight to the ground.